Lymphedema is diagnosed in the clinic, on a clinic level, in several ways. First, most obviously, is physical examination and taking a patient history. We also visually look at the limb. We palpate, or we touch the limb. We want to get a feel for what the skin feels like. Is it feel like on the normal side, or is it feeling a little boggy? I love that term. It's a strong medical term. Does it feel hard? Are there skin changes? And then also, too, we take measurements. So we take circumferential measurements. So we'll start down at the hand, work our way up the wrist, go in our clinic, we go every 10 centimeters, take a measurement. We can plug that in and get a volumetric measurement, get a circumferential measurement, compare it to the uninvolved arm, and we can get a feel for just how much swelling there is. That's on a clinical basis when you can see some evidence of swelling. On a subclinic level, it's not used as a form of diagnosis for lymphedema, but it does give us kind of a heads up that there might be something going on. It's what's bioimpedance, which is an l-dex measurement. What they use is a very, very low electric charge that goes through, and they measure one arm to the other arm. It's done on a unilateral basis, one arm involvement. So we can kind of get an idea of what is the relative amount of fluid. And the way they do that is that electrical charge travels through the fluid that's in the arm. The more fluid, the faster it travels. So obviously then that gives us an idea. And then there's a range of what's normal and what's abnormal. And then if it's abnormal, then we can proceed with other course of action. But as far as really doing a diagnosis, it would be done, as I said, history, physical, look at the tissues, feel the tissues, take measurements of the tissues, and go from there.